Okay. There we go.
This must be the way forward, but to where?
That was close. Got him.
It is a book after all.
You wanted to see me, Headmistress Fitzgerald, Professor Rackham.
Miss Isadora Morganach, welcome.
Professor Rookwood, Professor Bacall.
We understand that you are adjusting well to life at Hogwarts.
I am.
I am glad. Especially in light of your unusual situation, starting as a fifth year.
As it happens, I was also admitted to Hogwarts as a fifth year. I have never heard of another like us.
Miss Morganach, when we spoke yesterday after class, you asked about the beautiful swirls you saw years ago when we visited your hamlet.
I recognized you all immediately. I cannot thank you enough for what you did.
We were glad to help.
And yes, I did see swirls of magic everywhere that day. My father insists it was my imagination running wild, but it was certainly real to me.
It was not your imagination.
Percival, Professor Rackham can see them too, but we have never known of another who could.
I don't understand. What are they?
The whispers or traces that appear when a particular form of ancient magic is wielded.
Ancient magic?
Few are capable of wielding it. Hogwarts itself is a stronghold of ancient magic.
So if I can see traces of ancient magic, does that mean I can wield it too?
With the proper training.
But let us not get ahead of ourselves, Miss Morganach.
Before I can train you to wield such magic, you must first master all that Hogwarts has to offer.
A magic this powerful can do great harm in the wrong hands. It must be wielded by a select few. As such, we ask that you not speak to anyone about what we have discussed here today.
Sebastian.
Sneaking in the restricted section again! I had thought we were through with this mischief. Clearly, detentions are insufficient. I'm afraid I must take this to the headmaster.
But that being said, Peeves informs me that you didn't come alone tonight. If someone has coerced you, I would have you tell me. You're a bright boy. Don't waste this.
There was nobody else. I came alone.
Oh, Sebastian. What will your uncle say?
You cannot be serious. Goblins working with Rookwood makes no sense.
It is rather unorthodox.
Dude looks like Snape.
Unorthodox? It's inconceivable. It's... Ah, Fig. You have a visitor. I'll see what I can find out.
Sir, I was able to search the restricted section while you were with Professor Black. It was a book we were after.
What? That's... Wait. You accessed the restricted section? But how? Thinking on it, perhaps it's best you spare me the details.
Fair enough. In fact, the book was below the restricted section, as it appeared on the map.
I want to hear everything. First, let's have a look. Oh dear. Some of these pages seem to be missing. It appears someone has got to the book before us. Still, I will need time to study what remains. Perhaps we can still salvage something useful, though it may take some time. I wonder why it was here, below Hogwarts.
I think I know, sir. I saw two more memories where I found the book.
Another pensive. Godric's heart.
The man we saw before, Percival Rackham, was a professor here. The first memory showed him and three other professors using ancient magic to restore a hamlet from a drought.
Miriam was right. And the second memory?
They were talking to a student who started as a fifth year, like I did. She could see traces of magic too.
Why those memories? Perhaps this book will explain. Now I'll have to take it with me to London. The headmaster has insisted that I speak directly to the minister about George's death.
What will you tell them about Mr. Osric's death?
I don't know how much I dare say. George tried to convince the ministry about Ranrok, but to no avail. My instinct is to follow the path we are on for the moment and keep the details to ourselves until we know more.
I understand. I'll see what I can learn about the missing pages while you're gone.
Good. Don't neglect your studies. Your wand work is improving by the day. But you'll want to pay attention in herbology and potions. There's more to magic than spell casting.
Plenty to keep me occupied while you're gone.
You've done exceptionally well. I look forward to seeing all that you've accomplished when I return. Oh, and don't neglect your friends. You may be surprised by how much you can learn from them as well.
Alrighty. Let us see now. Well, I like the orbicular handle. I'm gonna equip that one. And equip these leather gloves too. Increased offense by 10. Actually, I kind of dig the green. Yeah, I kind of dig the emerald cloak. Makes me look like a Slytherin, but I dig it. All right. Now, do I want to equip any? I don't really like the headwear. Maybe that's just me, but I don't really care about the headwear that much.
Meet me in Lower Hogsfield as soon as possible. I would like to talk to you about Rookwood and Harlow, and it might be best to do so outside of the castle.
It's time to prove your dueling mettle and see if we've a new school champion. Meet me at the usual place for the final round of crossed wands. Also, the training dummy is still available.
Okay, so there's a cross wand side quest. There's a lot of side quests.
I teach you an additional defensive spell. Please complete the assignments I have given you, and then proceed to see me in my classroom.
Alright, now I need to send you an outpost request to meet her in Lower Hogsfield, a hamlet. This is the world map. Most maps are covered by fog, limiting what you can see. Hamlets are small communities throughout the world. This is the hamlet, Lower Hogsfield. Hamlets provide new opportunities for vendors, flu flames, side quests, and collectibles. As you explore, you will move fog and reveal more of the map, unveiling new opportunities like hamlets, dungeons, bandit camps, and many other locations. So we have a couple of main quests we can do. Like herbology, obviously. Well, you can learn Expelliarmus. That could come in handy. Let's do that first, before we do the next dueling thing. Because I'm actually really liking the dueling side missions.
Revelio.
Hello there. Perhaps you can help me.
Hello? Were you calling me?
I was, yes. Thought perhaps a fellow Hufflepuff might have the perseverance to join me in a bit of an adventure. Following a treasure map, to be precise. Slight respite from battling the odd troll, I should think. Asked Poppy if she'd be interested as well, but couldn't drag her away from her puff skein. I found two maps lying about, both leading to locations around Hogwarts. Care to have a look at one?
Following a Hogwarts treasure map. Count me in.
Wonderful! Hogwarts fascinates me. You can keep whatever treasure lies at the end of your map. I'll be satisfied just knowing where it leads.
Where do you suggest I search first?
Based on a cursory review of your map, I'd suggest somewhere near Hecate's classroom.
Very well. I shall take a look if I can find the time.
Fair enough. Meet me back here if you find anything.
Professor, do you have time to chat?
I always have time for my students. How may I help you?
How long have you taught here?
I wondered if I might ask how long you've been teaching at Hogwarts.
Well, it's been what now? 7 swift years. Time does fly because we have fun. Essential, in my opinion. An eager, positive, and confident mind is the most open to knowledge, I find.
Some of the professors may not agree with your approach.
Well, each of us has our own style, I suppose. Some in the teaching field believe that hard work and dedication are the only keys to success. But they forget what drives those things. If one cannot fathom why some would expend energy on gobstones, then one is blind to the enormous power of play.
And that's why you teach the way you do?
Precisely. I strive to be the sort of professor that I would have enjoyed in school. My experience was less cheerful.
Perhaps you wouldn't be who you are without that experience.
Had I received a more traditional education, well, enough about my student days. You are here now, and it would be a shame if you didn't enjoy it.
I'll do my best, Professor. Thank you for the advice.
You are most welcome. try to have a bit of fun today.
Huh? Okay. Another damn thing locked, of course it is.
Revelio.
The mind.
Here we go.
Ah, a rhinoceros skeleton. I'm on the right track.
Is it not like tracking these or like what's going on? It's probably because they have class, isn't it? See, it's not giving me a tracking thing for this. Not where I wanted to travel. Yeah, let's track the main quest actually then, because I don't know if it's going to let me do the side quest right now. It's not leading me to the class I want to go to. I seriously already forgot my way to Hecate's class. Sorry, I mean to shove you.
Professor Garlic. How wonderful it is to see you again, Lenora dear. Oh, here. You'll need these for today's class. A little treat for your auntie. Ah, hello. Class, please welcome the newest rose in our garden. We do look forward to growing together. How thrilling it is to have everyone back together again. This year will be filled with enchantment and excitement, but the most important thing cultivated in herbology is knowledge. The prudent herbologist is no more afraid of the venomous tentacular than the bouncing bulb. Now then, today we will be acquainting ourselves with the mellifluous tuber known as the mandrake root. Accio. Let's see if we can't make our fibrous friends a bit more comfortable, shall we? First, let's protect our ears. Now, everyone, grip their mandrake by the tendrils and give it a firm tug.
You knew that was going to happen.
The soil should envelop the root like a warm, dirty blanket, putting the mandrake right at ease. Repairer! I'm very sorry about that. Yours was a bit mature, I'm afraid. All right then, off you go. Splendid work, everyone. Now for our next task, we'll be planting Dittany at our potting tables. You can all get...
I wonder if hippogriffs like knot grass.
Yes, Professor.
Firstly, well done with your mandrake. They can be rather difficult to get a grasp of.
I hear they went deaf. No, I'll say I enjoyed it.
Actually, I enjoyed it. I couldn't help but catch your enthusiasm.
How kind of you. It seems you're already taking to herbology like a mandrake to fresh soil. Now, as I mentioned, next we'll be planting Dittany. Let us find you some seeds.
I already have some, Professor. Pick them up in Hogsmeade.
You visited the Magic Neep. Wonderful! A prepared student is bound to bloom. I've arranged for you to have your own potting table here in the classroom. Wasn't easy to spare one on such late notice. Plant the seeds there now, and you can return to harvest them later. Even with soil, sunlight, and a bit of magic, they will take time to grow.
Let's see how to balance my star thistle arrangement. Mifflin's Fancy or roses?
Dittany's restorative properties make it a vital ingredient in the Wiganweld potion, as you all should know from Professor Sharp's class. Well done! Once it can be harvested, your Dittany will be ready to use in Wiganweld potion. I'll let Professor Sharp tell you about that. Now, what say we branch out? Introduce you to a different sort of flora, the Chinese chomping cabbage. You'll find that some plants are better suited to uses outside of a cauldron. The cabbages do get testy without something to chew. Fortunately, I have a dummy for them to gnaw on. Be a dear and let them have a good chomping.
Yes, Professor.
They're in the other greenhouse. It's just at the end of the footbridge leading out of this room. Your classmate, Mr. Pruitt, has kindly offered to accompany you. Come back and see me when you're finished. Oh, and mind your fingers. They do bite.
All right. Now we have to go meet Leander Pruitt.
Hello. Saw you on your way to Hogsmeade the other day. Nice to meet you. I'm Leander. I'll be showing you the Chinese chomping cabbages. Up these stairs will take us there. But your lead.
Oh, so you want me to lead first? Okay.
Nice work in Defense Against the Dark Arts, by the way.
Excuse me?
Your duel with Sebastian. And he's good. Thinks he's really good. But you outright slaughtered him. It was brilliant. Here we are. Home of the Chinese chomping cabbage. Go on. Grab a few of those cabbages. Just now, see that dummy? Just toss the cabbages at it, and they'll do the rest.
Hold L1 and tap R to open the tool wheel and assign the Chinese chomping cabbages, and tap L1 to use the assigned tools.
Look at that! That's not anything they can get their mouths on. Mum planted some in her garden last year to keep the gnomes out. Did save her the denoming, but they left her honking daffodils in tatters.
I'm sorry. What do I need to do?
Garlic said she wanted you to have a go at tending the cabbages. Give them some time to chomp and whatnot. Nothing to it, really. Just toss some of those Chinese chomping cabbages out. You'll see fairly quickly why we call them that. Vicious little bastards, aren't they? My kind of plants. Not like stupid booba tubers and bouncing bulbs. The kind of plants that'd have your back in a fight. Not saying you can't go it alone, but, well, imagine that wasn't a dummy.
Suppose they could come in handy.
I suppose they could prove useful outside of the greenhouse. Nothing wrong with a bit of backup, even if it is from a cabbage.
It's chaos out there. Trolls in Hogsmeade and such. You can't be above throwing a cruciferous vegetable if necessary. Dogweed and Deathcap has more of them, if you're keen. Other plants too. Ones your parents wouldn't plant in the garden. You get the idea. Anyway, we probably ought to head back to class. Take your time. I'll see you back in class.
Go ahead and gather the rest of these. Collect some Dittany when we're at it too.
Reminder as to why we should always wear our dragon hide.
The best time to plant a seed is last season. The second best time is now.
I tended to the Chinese chomping cabbages, Professor.
Remarkable plants, aren't they? I hope they weren't too much trouble. Oh, don't see any bite marks or missing digits. And good, as you do seem to be quite green-fingered. Oh, I'm eager to see your skill in the soil continue to blossom.
Don't care much for plants, honestly.
Magical plants have so much to offer. I'm eager to learn more.
I'm glad. Herbology is a bounteous subject. Tend to your garden, and it will tend to you. Huh. Well, I suppose that's everything. Do come by for a chat sometime. I so enjoy checking in with my new students.
Alright.
Really relishing their new pots. Through my damned hearing.
To make anything grow, we must first understand it. That goes for plants as well as friendships. Kindness and concern are as necessary in the greenhouse as in the Great Hall.
Did you know that you can use the mandrake to defend yourself? Why, the very idea.
Off on another adventure, are we?
I should think Professor Garlic would be more careful with her mandrakes.
I do wonder about Professor Fig. He's hardly ever in his classroom. Most strange.
Sojin's class is next. And that's downstairs in the dungeons.
I haven't been feeling myself at all.
Maybe auras or no. Someone from the ministry guarding the school after the incident in Hogsmeade.
Professor Blackwood.
On about the Goblin Rebellion.
Potions is one of the most challenging and hazardous subjects taught at this school. As fifth years, you will be required to reach new heights of both discipline and intellect. You will begin this term by brewing a Wigan Weld potion. Mr. Takar, can you tell us why this particular potion might come in handy?
Yes, Professor Sharp. The Wigan Weld potion can be used to sterilize and even heal a variety of injuries.
It can heal some injuries, but not all. Points for Ravenclaw. Before today's class is completed, each of you will have brewed a Wigan Weld potion of your own. You never know when you might need it. Please begin. Use a strong, even motion when crushing your ingredients. Please be meticulous when adding powder to your potions. One errant sneeze could be disastrous.
This reminds me of the potion-making game from the Half-Blood Prince tie-in. If you guys remember seeing me play that a long time ago. Oh, it was so fun. Frustrating, but fun.
I see most of you have not forgotten how to stir. Not an easy potion to brew. Well done. And from what I hear of your recent exploits in Hogsmeade, you'd also do well to practice brewing the defensive Edurus potion. Professor Weasley had you acquire the recipe from J. Pippin's, correct?
Yes, sir.
Good. For the moment, you can find the ingredients you need in my office. But in the future, you'll be expected to provide your own ingredients. Some can be harvested from the plants you grow in your herbology class, and rarer ones can be purchased. Others, however, may be harder to obtain. And will require you to be a bit more resourceful. Come and see me when you've finished brewing. And we'll see if it was skill or luck the first time around.
Alright.
My parents considered keeping me home from school this year after the rumors of a...
Did I hear Professor Sharp say that you have permission to go into his office?
Gareth Weasley.
He did say that. He wants me to get more ingredients to brew another potion.
Brilliant! You, my friend, have been presented with an extraordinary opportunity. I'm Gareth, by the way. Gareth Weasley. Bit of a prodigy with potions, if I do say so myself.
Pleasure to meet you. Wait, are you related to Professor Weasley?
She's my aunt. Keeps too close an eye on me for comfort. Ugh. But she can't be everywhere. Listen, anyone with a troll-sized brain can brew an Edurus potion. I'm working on something that's certain to be spectacular. I'm just missing one tiny last ingredient that will add that extra spark.
I suspect that's where I come in.
You're as clever as I'd hoped. I simply need a single Thwooper feather. As you'll already be in Sharp's office with his permission, perhaps you could grab it for me.
I'm not sure that's a good idea.
I don't know, Gareth. I don't want to get on Sharp's bad side.
You won't. Thwooper feathers aren't that valuable. Sharp won't even miss it.
Sorry.
I've enough to worry about collecting the ingredients he wants me to get. I'm afraid I can't help you.
I understand. I'll sort something else out.
Hey, don't risk getting in trouble now.
Remember,
knowing your second day in school.
Thank you.
Purple Dragonite Spectacles. Hang on a second. I gotta be level 8 to wear those. You can't even see what they look like on you. That sucks.
Your potion should not be that color, Miss Mc. Should you chop the dittany or crush it? The wrong answer could result in the unfortunate loss of your eyebrows.
And now we add the mallow sweet, and that's odd. What's happening? Wait, it's not supposed to.
Get it! Again.
Oh! Dragon duck! What happened?
Well done, Gareth.
What now, Mr. Weasley?
Sorry, Professor.
That'll be points from Gryffindor, again.
I brewed an Edorus potion as you asked, Professor.
Glad you managed to stay on task. Not every class is so eventful. I saw Mr. Weasley speaking with you earlier. He can be quite persuasive. Glad you managed to resist. You've done well today. I confess I was skeptical, given the advanced nature of this class and the fact you're a new student.
I'm glad I was able to meet your expectations.
A rare occurrence. And you do well to remember that you're not a potions master quite yet. In addition to having a solid grasp of how to combine various ingredients, you should gain an understanding of the ingredients themselves. Pay particular attention in herbology. The plants you nurture there are often essential to the potions you brew here. Now, I recommend that you find a safe location in which to practice brewing. You cannot leave a hot cauldron simply anywhere. That'll be all.
Okay.
I think each of us...
Don't fret if you run out of ingredients. I simply grow most of what I need.
Professor Sharp must have learned a lot during his time as an Auror. I wish he talked about it more.
That was an interesting class.
Wasn't precisely what I had in mind, but it was still brilliant. Thought for certain you'd have helped.
I'm glad I avoided trouble. Sharp certainly seemed upset with you.
His bark's worse than his bite. I think deep down he respects my artistic spirit. Sharp may seem gruff, but I'd bet a few galleons he blew up a potion or two in his day. Best be off. Next time we talk, I promise, fewer explosions.
You say that now. Oh, in a couple of years, one of your fucking descendants is gonna be like one of the worst students in potions. I'm referring to Ron, by the way.
Ugh, my robes are going to reek from Gareth's inspiration.
It's been a week. How nice to see you, my young friend.
There you go, that's where I want to go. Go to Professor Hackett. Because now we've done our two classes for the day. Turns out, oh, there she is.
Professor, I wondered, did you attend Hogwarts?
I did. I am a proud member of Ravenclaw House. Why do you ask?
I was curious as to how Hogwarts has changed over the years.
I see. Well, the castle itself, as I'm sure you have surmised, is full of surprises. I dare say more than the staircases change around here. As for the students, well, they seem to get more capable every year. Although, we got up to just as much mischief in my day as you seem to now. I used to look the other way at all sorts of roguery when I was head girl. I can tell you, however, that I did once admonish a certain Phineas Nigellus Black for enjoying a sugar quill during a lecture.
I hadn't realized that you and Professor Black were, students here together.
Appearances can be deceiving. You see, I was once wounded by time itself.
I'm not sure what that means, but it sounds horrible.
Ah, well, it was the risk I took with my prior position. You may or may not have heard that I was an unspeakable at the Ministry for years.
An unspeakable? What does...
As you might suspect, I cannot speak about what we did. Suffice it to say, the job was not without its hazards. Now, I hope I've satisfied your curiosity for the moment.
You have. Thank you for speaking with me, Professor.
Keep up with your wand work. One must always be prepared for mischief, both inside and outside of the castle.
Excuse me, Professor. Could you remind me what my assignments were about?
Professors Weasley and Fig asked that I teach you the disarming charm, Expelliarmus. Once you complete the assignments I've given, we can begin your instruction.
Okay.
Revelio.
Actually see, what are my tasks for that one quest? Successfully avoid enemy attacks by dodge rolling and cast incendio on enemies 5 times. Alright. Make sure I have all my attack spells. All right.
Hello, Lucan. Is the final round of crossed wands ready?
big match today. It all comes down to this. The moment that we find out if your training and dedication is enough to win it all. Ready for a shot at glory?
I certainly am.
Brilliant. Are you dealing with a partner?
Yes, Sebastian.
Then let's get started.
We can make this a real victory.
That's the spirit.
Four of them? Okay, red shields with Incendio, purple shields are Accio, and yellow shields are Levioso. God damn.
They made a crap's breakfast out of you that round. Care to try again?
Yes, I'm ready now.
Very well. Good luck out there.
Alright. I freaking. It literally didn't heal me.
Care to try again?
Yes, I'm ready now.
Very well. Good luck out there.
What the? From what?
Care to try again?
Yes, I'm ready now.
Very well. Good luck out there. Again?
No, I don't think so. Not right now.
Understandable.
The way he sounds so defeated at this point. The fuck?
We'll be waiting.
He's like, no, I've learned my lesson.